Hi everyone, I'm Fabrizio, I'm from Italy, and I'm doing a PhD at UCL School of Pharmacy in London. I'm working on 3D printing in collaboration with FabRx, and during my project I'm basically printing oral formulations using 3D printing. We are actually the first group in the world to investigate selective laser sintering to make medicine.
My name is Professor Simon Gaisford. I work at UCL. I'm head of pharmaceutics, and I'm also director and co-founder of FabRx. We originally looked at 3D printing as a research tool, and then we decided there was a commercial opportunity. So we set up FabRx as a spin-out from the university, and its specific aim is to focus and develop on 3D printing for pharmaceutical dosage forms.
We were very interested in selective laser sintering because we don't need to use a liquid as a binder, we just use a powder and a laser. And the precision of the laser is something we were looking for.
So one of our research directors found Sintratec as a manufacturer of SLS systems, and it was a system that we hadn't been able to purchase before because the cost is very high. But because you supply a system which can be kit built, it was a very affordable system. And so it was an opportunity to explore a technology we couldn't use before.
We bought our first Sintratec kit, and then we tried to print the first tablets using paracetamol, and we managed to print them. So we dissolved those tablets, we checked the amount of drug inside, and surprisingly we realized there was no drug degradation. The drug was still there, and it was a very, very happy moment. By 3D printing, we can personalize medicine. We can make tablets with unconventional 3D structures, and we can make tablets with different releases profile just by changing the printing parameters. The big advantage of the Sintratec kit is actually we can customize the printing parameters. We can choose the ideal temperature and the ideal laser speed. We can start from 1 millimeter per second up to 1000 millimeter per second. And in that big range, we can actually make very, very different products with different strengths, which dissolve at different times just by changing the laser speed. We use the printers actually every day. We need to optimize the printing process, find the right parameters. We are testing new polymers, and every printing process might last 20 minutes, and I'm able to print up to 20 tablets. We started using the Sintratec kit 2 years ago. It was in 2017. Since then, we already published 4 articles in International Journal of Pharmaceutics. We started to have more ideas. That's when we decided to invest on a second kit. And since then, our research is much, much faster, and we can be much more effective.
I think of all the techniques that we've evaluated, laser sintering is up there as one that we think is one of the most promising techniques for bringing products to market. It means that we can make an almost infinite number of doses, so we can tailor a dose to a patient. We can put more than one active into a particular dosage form. And so to be able to formulate drugs for very small numbers of patient groups is going to allow us to offer medication for people with rare or poorly studied diseases. And I think that is fundamentally going to change the way that the pharmaceutical industry has to formulate drugs.
I see a very big potential on this technology, and I'm sure in the future this technology will play a major role in the pharmaceutical industry.